you to take yourself to Ezekiel 26. And the reason I want you to do that is Ezekiel chapter 26 has as its theme the judgment against Tyre, and it actually picks up where Isaiah 23 left off, and it gives us more direct proclamation. It predicts exactly what would happen to Tyre. And so pick up with me in chapter 26 of Ezekiel. Now you have to think for just a second that Isaiah 23 is written in the late 700s BC. And now we have chapter 26 of Ezekiel dated for us in the first verse. So Isaiah prophesies that Tyre will fall, and he prophesies that in, you know, the late 700s BC. And now verse 1 of Ezekiel 26 says, "It came to pass on the 11th year, on the first day of the month, that the word of the Lord came to me." And so if you do the math on this and do the history, Ezekiel is writing in 586 BC. It's the same year that Jerusalem falls. Nebuchadnezzar encroaches into that area on the Mediterranean to Palestine, Israel, the ancient land of Canaan. And so in 586 BC, what happens is Ezekiel is given a word of the Lord, and the word says, verse 2, "Son of man, because Tyre has said against Jerusalem, 'Aha! She is broken who was the gateway of the peoples. Now she is turned over to me. I shall be filled. She is laid waste.' Therefore, says the Lord God, 'Behold, I am against you, O Tyre, and will cause many nations to come up against you.'" And so because of Tyre rejoicing over the fact that Babylon had sacked Jerusalem, and they were rejoicing that they were going to have some ill-gotten gain from this, God says, "Well, that's enough. It's one thing for you to infect my people with your Canaanite gods. It's one thing for you to kind of have this weird mixed marriage. It's another thing for them to not drive you out. But finally, this is the last straw that you've rejoiced when they fell." And remember, as we look through the Old Testament, never is God happy when people rejoice over other people's failures and them falling, no matter how wicked. So that said, therefore, God says, "Behold, I'm against you, O Tyre," verse 3, "and will cause," notice this, "many nations to come up against you, as the sea causes its waves to come up. And they," these many nations, "shall destroy the walls of Tyre and break down her towers. I will also scrape her from the dust, and I'll make her like the top of a rock. I'll scrape her dust from her and make her like the top of a rock. And it shall be a place for the spreading of nets," that's fishing nets, "in the midst of the sea, for I have spoken, says the Lord God. And it shall become a plunder for the nations." Also, verse 6 says, "Her daughter villages, which are in the fields, shall be slain by the sword. And then they shall know that I am the Lord. For thus says," verse 7, "the Lord God, 'Behold, I will bring against Tyre from the north,'" just like Isaiah 23 predicted, "'the Chaldeans, Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon," king of the Chaldeans, king of kings, "with horses, with chariots, and with horsemen, and an army with many people. And notice, he will slay with the sword your daughter villages in the fields. He will heap up a siege mound," that's key, "against you. He'll build a wall against you and raise a defense against you. He will direct his battering rams against your walls, and with his axes he will break down your towers. Because of the abundance of his horses, their dust will cover you. Your walls will shake at the noise of the horsemen, the wagons, and the chariots when he enters your gates as men enter a city that has been breached. With hooves of his horses, he," all this is Nebuchadnezzar and his armies, "will trample all your streets. He will slay your people by the sword, and your strong pillars will fail, or they'll fall all the way to the ground. Now notice there's a change in verse 12. They will plunder your riches and pillage your merchandise. They will break down your walls and destroy your pleasant houses. They will lay your stones, your timber, your soil in the midst of the water. And I will put an end to the sound of your songs, this is God, and the sound of your harps shall be heard no more. I will make you like the top of a rock, said again, you will be a place for spreading of nets, and you shall never be rebuilt, for I, the Lord God, have spoken. Now we think about this amazing detailed proclamation against Tyre. I mean, all the details of how Tyre would fall. Then we have to ask ourselves, well, what's history say about this?